If it's your first time here, remember, like, subscribe, and drop a comment. So a lot of students tend to lose the essence of what they're doing, especially in 3702. 3702, basically, it's external auditing. So basically, don't forget, you are at that enterprise because you want to sign off a report at the end of the day. So each and everything, how you're going to be attempting your material, understand and always conscientize yourself. Keep on reminding yourself that I'm here to overly give a report. I have to give a report on the state of the financials of this organization. A lot of students tend to miss it along the way. Then you get the whole picture confused. Don't forget, in this particular module, you are an external auditor. You are not part of the company. So basically, whatever information you're going to be given in a scenario, you just have to exclude yourself from it. For instance, your lecturers can give you a balance for debtors control, for instance, or trade and other receivables, for instance. They give you a trade and other receivable balance of 1.5 million. A lot of students make a mistake of not vouching or not performing procedures on that balance that they're given because for some odd reason, not known to me, they believe that the moment they see the lecturer is putting that balance in a scenario, that balance has to be accurate. And then they look for other procedures besides the procedures of actually making sure that that 1.5 is actually accurate. So don't get it twisted by scenarios. Remember, you are there to give an audit opinion at the end of the day. Whatever procedures that you have to generate, whatever, anything that you'll be doing within the context of your examination paper, the whole idea is for you to be able to give a report on the state of affairs of that company. So try as much as you can not to get confused when the lecturer gives you information. Try to exclude yourself from that information. Yes, it's a great technique, especially in preparation for examinations, where you exclude yourself like you include yourself in the information that's given. They give you a scenario about a company XYZ. How you see yourself at that company is going to help you. How you're going to be seeing yourself at that company XYZ is going to help you answer the question. Because if you're going to be seeing yourself as someone who's outside of it, yes, you're going to struggle with answering. But as you see yourself inside XYZ, remember, you're still an external auditor. You are still an external auditor. I'm not sure how I can stress the importance of this, so that when you read the scenario, all the information that's there has to be vouched. All the information that's there, you can't take it as true. In all other modules, accounting, financial accounting, management accounting, all other modules, when the lecturer gives you a scenario, you have to take the scenario as correct and everything. But in auditing, you have to apply a degree of professional skepticism. If you don't apply a degree of professional skepticism, you are going to find yourself struggling in answering an auditing O2 question or an external auditing question. So make sure as you read the information, remember, please, 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 remember that you are an external, you're not part of it. So even if they say the assets, where this is an asset balance, this is a trial balance, this is a statement of cash flow, whatever statement they throw at you, you mustn't take it at face value. That is something that they try to make sure that you understand, you're still aware that, okay, in this module, I'm supposed to think and behave like an external auditor. I hope this helps you in your examination preparation, in your studies, as you are going to be doing auditing. Make sure you can exclude yourself and remember that you're still an external auditor. Don't take the things that they've put there as truths. It's going to cost you and you won't be able to perform all the audit procedures. Because sometimes students, you get overwhelmed. They are looking for audit procedures and the question is worth 25 marks. They are looking for audit procedures, the question is worth 17 marks. Your mind starts racing all over the show, but really, it's so simple scoring all the 17 marks if you are able to remember you are an external factor. You're not part of that team. You're not part of ABC. You are at ABC as an external factor. And as you are there to write a report on the state of affairs. We had a lot of stories in the news. It's too much now. Where audit firms are sued by companies for saying, yes, the statements were okay, but at the end of the day, there's a problem. So this is actually a very serious profession where it is actually preparing you to get to a point where you have to make sure that you value your signature. And before you give out your signature, everything has been washed and everything there, you know for sure that 10 years later, if they're still going to come back to something that you've done, everything is okay. So the lecturers try to recreate that in the form of an exam. It's never going to be direct. It's never going to be direct. Please, as you attempt your papers, make triple sure you understand your position in a scenario. You understand your position in a scenario. Do not forget the whole purpose of this entire module is for us to have an external auditor at the end of the day. Thank you so much for taking time to watch this video. Remember, like, share, subscribe, drop a comment. Cheers.